Greetings all, welcome to my video. From the eventchronicle.com. Former RAF officer recalls mind-blowing UFO encounter in 1985. By Nirmal Narayanan. A former Royal Air Force, UK, officer who served the force from 1941 to 1946, has opened up about some UFO encounter he had in 1985. The man who wished to be unnamed, revealed that he had witnessed a triangular UFO, hovering over Boreham Wood in Britain. The man had also served in the Ministry of Defence from 1949 to 1977. The man says that he does not have any explanation for this sighting, despite tracking the skies professionally for the past 3 decades. I rather doubt that I am easily deceived by aerial phenomena. My distinct impression is that I perceived an event for which no ready explanation is possible in wholly conventional terms. Astronomical phenomena are, I think, ruled out by the extensive cloud cover, as well as by the very regular, triangular formation of the three lights seen, said the former RAF officer, Express.co.uk reports. He even ruled out the possibility of this vehicle being an aircraft, as there is no known aircraft in the world with such a shape. Soon after the sighting, he reported the incident to the Ministry of Defence. According to the report, he saw an array of triangular lights heading southwest while he was in his friend's garden. He told the MOD that the UFO produced no sound, and it hovered above the cloud for more than 3 minutes. This is not the first time that the report of a triangular UFO is surfacing online. Recently, a similar phenomenon was reported in Switzerland, where a young woman saw a triangular UFO from her kitchen during the wee hours of the night. In the meantime, a section of conspiracy theorists believes that 2018 will turn out to be the year of disclosure. They claim that governments and space agencies, including NASA, will reveal the existence of extraterrestrials this year. Nirmal Narayanan is a regular contributor to the International Business Times. Disclosure update: Britain's declassified X-Files may prove military UFO cover-up. By Justin Deshaw. The UK Ministry of Defence, MOD, recently declassified a set of documents related to encounters with UFOs. The 15 documents were published by Britain's National Archives, but in paper form only. For some odd reason, the files are not being digitized, and instead must be viewed in person, or purchased directly from the National Archives. Many in the ufology community have been hoping that the files disclose information on the Rendlesham Forest incident, arguably Britain's most famous UFO sighting. So far, none of the newly declassified files refer to the Rendlesham Forest sightings, but one of them does offer new information on another famous British UFO encounter, which took place near the coastal town of Skegness, on England's east coast. Source: Mysterious Universe. By Brett Tingley. The sighting took place near the Wash, a bay and estuary in East Anglia. The sighting has since come to be known as the Wash Incident, or Boston Stump Incident. On October 5, 1996, Skegness residents, police officers, and the crew of a nearby tanker, spotted a strange aircraft hovering above the Wash, a bay south of Skegness. The object was described as a rotating disc, with red and blue lights. Police and Coast Guard officials noticed the Royal Air Force, RAF, which located the object using military and air traffic radars. Whatever the object was, it did not emit a transponder signal, and hovered in place for over 7 hours. Of course, the usual explanations have been thrown around: celestial objects and atmospheric distortion, but many witnesses reject those explanations. A still from a video of the object shot by the Boston, Lincolnshire police. One of these newly declassified documents contains a letter written by an unnamed government official, reportedly Labour MP Martin Redmond, to the former UK Defence Secretary, Michael Portillo. The letter asks for an explanation why the RAF was told to ignore the object, and not scramble aircraft for surveillance, in spite of numerous radar and visual confirmations from law enforcement. Whoever the author was, they raised serious concerns about the way the sighting was dismissed by the highest levels of UK military and government. "I am very concerned about an incident that occurred off the Anglian coast recently, involving a visual unidentified flying craft sighting, which was correlated by various different military radar systems. This raises serious issues about the way in which we police the UK's air defence region. The RAF is supposed to, or so I believed, to be keeping a watchful eye on activity in the UK, but seem to have no idea what is going on. Do they have standard procedure for these incidents? They had enough time to think about it, because the object was on our radar for upwards of 7 hours. While conspiracy theorists might see this as evidence of a cover-up, the explanation might be benign. The MOD's official explanation was that the radar signature away, as the result of interference from a nearby church spire. Such a permanent radar echo was known to happen in the past, so it makes sense that the RAF might have dismissed this sighting, if they were familiar with interference in the area. Images of the newly declassified documents, which are not yet in digital form. After investigating the incident, the RAF declared research has not revealed evidence that alarming or extraordinary events were being witnessed. The source of the lights seen by numerous credible witnesses remains a mystery, for most familiar with the case, however. Could multiple witnesses, Skegness police, and a tanker crew mistake Venus, and various stars, for a rotating, hovering aircraft? Possible, but maybe not plausible. Stranger things have happened, though. Unfortunately, these files shed little new light on this case. About the author. Brett Tingley is a writer and musician living in the ancient Appalachian Mountains. Another astronaut shares his thoughts on extraterrestrial visitation, and the origin of the human race. By Arjun Walia. The list of astronauts who have shared their knowledge and beliefs about UFOs and intelligent extraterrestrial civilizations that are, or have been visiting our planet is extensive, and growing. Apollo 14 astronaut Dr. Edgar Mitchell, for instance, once told us there have been crashed craft, and bodies recovered, and Dr. Brian O'Leary told the world, there is abundant evidence that we are being contacted. Still more, like Gordon Cooper, and Story Musgrave, have all made some interesting remarks about this topic. Also joining them is a long and growing list of hundreds, if not thousands of high-ranking military personnel, political figures, academics, and many more. On top of this, we have hundreds of thousands of pages, released by multiple governments, that document these cases. Although we may not know exactly what is going on, we know something is. All of this information that's leaked over the past few years, has also provoked a response from mainstream media outlets, which used to criticize and ridicule the subject. Now, they are taking corrective measures to bring more credibility to this topic, if poorly. This has been seen with recent citizens' hearings about UFOs, as well as celebrities like Tom DeLonge, creating awareness initiatives in conjunction with people from major corporations and intelligence agencies. Take the founder of Bigelow Aerospace, for example, who is one of many, who has shared his knowledge about the fact that we are not alone, and that we are being visited. This subject has been swept under the radar by so many people, for so long, yet suddenly we've had this burst of information that's made it clear to most, that something is going on here. The more popular this subject gets, the more it enters the mainstream arena, and the more we need to put our critical thinking caps on. For years, governments and intelligence agencies have had a very heavy interest in this subject. All of the mainstream organizations created to investigate this phenomenon, like NICAP and MUFON, originate from the intelligence and defense community. This is a common trend with regards to mainstream initiatives dealing with the UFO, extraterrestrial subject. The point is, our government and mainstream media routinely deceive us about important topics. Yet people look to them as reliable sources of information, even though mainstream media has direct connections to the intelligence community, and is controlled by a small group of financial elite, with very specific agendas. There is news transpiring every day that should be making headlines, and never does. Instead, we are fed propaganda and lies, which is made even more clear by how often international media in other countries shares information that contradicts what is presented to us here in the West. The latest example would be Vladimir calling out the Syrian chemical weapons attack as a false flag. This is why the solution is not to censor information or deem it as fake news, but rather to have open discussions, teach people how to think critically, and examine sources for ourselves. We need to decide for ourselves what is real news, not let authority figures seeking personal gain and profit, often through military action, do it for us. So, when it comes to the UFO, extraterrestrial topic, why should we expect anything less than more misinformation? This type of thing has been seen within our media, and even academia, to sway or persuade a perception. Behind the scenes, high-ranking Air Force officers are soberly concerned about UFOs. But through official secrecy and ridicule, many citizens are led to believe the unknown flying objects are nonsense. Former head of CIA Roscoe Hill and Coter. While we've had many astronauts share their experiences, others are quick to dismiss any talk of UFOs, saying they have not personally come across any evidence to suggest that the phenomenon is real. This is quite confusing, and brings into question the possibility of two campaigns happening at the same time, one of ridicule, and one of misinformation. In the interview below, Al Worden shares his beliefs about extraterrestrials. We are the aliens, but we just think they're somebody else, but we're the ones who came from somewhere else. Because somebody else had to survive, and they got in a little spacecraft, and they came here, and they landed, and they started civilization here, that's what I believe. And if you don't believe me, go get books on the ancient Sumerians, and see what they had to say about it, they'll tell you right up front. His comments differ significantly from Dr. Edgar Mitchell's, who said he happens to be privileged enough to be in on the fact that we are not alone on this planet and that we have been visited many times. As far as humans coming from space, Worden astronaut is not the only one who has brought forth this theory. You can read more about that in the article linked below. This article, another astronaut shares his thoughts on alien visitation and the origin of the human race, was originally published on Collective Evolution and syndicated by the Event Chronicle. Thank you for watching. Please help spread the word and make a difference by sharing and subscribing for more thought-provoking content, and give us a thumbs up if you liked the video. Your support is greatly appreciated. Be aware and stay safe.